typically cartilage injuries are not the most common. I happen to see a fair amount of it in my practice. You can get knee cartilage injuries for a variety of reasons. You can have some congenital defects that you get in kids that I see called osteochondral lesions. You can also get direct impact cartilage injuries. You can get some overuse injuries. Oftentimes you can treat some non-operatively with therapy, anti-inflammatory medications, but sometimes they do lead to a surgery. And then the surgery again depends on the type of cartilage injury. In kids with the more congenital defects, you can repair it or you can stimulate growth to get those to heal. As we get older, the potential to heal the cartilage is definitely limited. Cartilage has a terrible propensity to heal to begin with. It's more of the underlying bone that you rely on. So in kids, that has a really good blood supply because of their open growth plates. As that closes, blood supply diminishes. And then that's why it's more difficult as we get older to heal from a cartilage injury. MACI is a procedure where you can take cartilage cells from a patient, and then a company called Vericell grows them up in a lab and then puts them on a porcine matrix. The matrix is a collagen membrane, so it looks like almost like a little piece of paper of collagen, which is a substance that naturally occurs in our bodies. It's a very interesting option for patients, and it's one that a lot of people don't realize, that you can regrow your cartilage if you have an injury. It's something that requires two surgeries. So the first surgery, you go in and you look at the cartilage defect. And then you actually take away some of the loose pieces of cartilage and then you stimulate some of the bone growth. Oftentimes people do well just from that. However, there are a subset of people that don't. And they still have pain, they still have swelling, they still have clicking, they still have symptoms from the cartilage defect. In those patients, it's then a second surgery. So in the second operation, you have to actually make an incision in the knee. And then you open up the knee joint and you look at the cartilage defect. And then you match the size and shape of the cartilage defect to a piece that you cut out from that matrix that you get. You then reimplant that into the knee and it can regrow your cartilage. This procedure isn't designed for someone with more widespread cartilage injury. It's really designed for someone with a focal cartilage injury. So it can't be done in someone with arthritis. Think of it as that you need good cartilage in order to regrow your cartilage. It's about 7 months of rehab that you have to do for this. The rehab's focused on getting your range of motion back, building up muscle, and then also time, because it takes a certain amount of time for this graft to heal and fill in with your new cartilage. You know, it's pretty amazing to see how they go from this painful range of motion, limited sports, limited activity, to going back to the things that they like to do. It's a little bit of instant gratification to kind of watch that recovery process.